ads will shut down, I think.
Okay.
I know personally, like, I'll want to shut off and just, you know,
withdraw.
Yeah, exactly that. Even that's the complete opposite of what I should do and what other people should do. In a sense, I actually need to go and, like, you know, talk to someone or,
yeah.
or
listen to other people.
Yeah, and there's still a little bit of a stigma around that.
And I think you've nicked the nail on the head. It's more the stigma is worse than the actual illness, almost. Not that it's an illness, but it's...
Yeah, sure.
It's because you have to... You're being quiet because of the fear of what other people may perceive. Whereas
yeah,
if
I mean,
you actually start
yeah.
earlier, you've got more chance of recovery.
Yeah, I think it's nipping
it
in the bud.
Yeah, so getting...
And sometimes that's literally just a conversation.
Yeah.
It's not anything serious. It doesn't
no.
you have to put a label on it. It's not
no.
an illness. It's
no.
any other. It's just I've been struggling for a couple
yeah.
of weeks.
Yeah.
You know, I need to kind of make a couple of people aware of this.
Yeah.
Because if you've got any kind of external pressure on you yeah. as well, and you bottle that up and you don't deal with it, that pressure starts building, and that's a slippery slope.
So it's kind of layer on layer on layer.
Yeah, it's just addressing it as early as you can, and I think especially with rugby, from professional level through to like your average
yeah.
pub side, to go out there for 80 minutes and belt each other about isn't normal in a
no.
sense. So therefore, if you're in that environment, you're gonna hide physical injuries. So you know you're gonna play with niggles, you can play with knocks. I think that reflects also on an emotional, mental side. So you're going to try and hide stuff because you don't really want to address it,
right.
and you just push through because you're used to it. That's what you do
right.
on a Sunday morning. You get through it. So, kind of making. If you're struggling, you're really struggling.
Yeah.
In a sense, like you need to. You're not milking it. You're not. You know, being soft, as we call it. It's.
Yeah.
You need to have a little chat with someone.
So kind of talking out is kind of, one, it's nipping it in the bud, and two, it's kind of maybe staying, showing strength to
yeah.
overcome things quicker than maybe if you haven't spoken out.
Yeah, it's exactly, yeah, in a sense it's having physical injuries, if you
yeah.
don't address it straight away,
yeah.
it's going to keep getting worse and worse
yeah, so
before you know it.
Yeah, I've got to mind this side.
It's a kind of serious, yeah, serious
yeah.
issue.
That's a real good parallel.
Mm. But the two keys are speaking up in the first place.
Yep, which is fabulous. Well done.
And the transition. But I think the one that is easier to address is the speaking up part. Because I think people have a perception that we're all like big alpha blokes who, you know, toughen up, get through
yeah.
it, this, that and the other. And there's a real difference between the physical side of
right.
like being out there and bashing lumps out of each other
yeah.
and the emotional side, the mental side. And actually, we're pretty aware of each other's struggles.
Yeah.
That's a good way of putting it. But it's a lot more open, I guess, because you're with each other every day.
Yeah.
And you go through quite a lot of
yeah.
tough experiences together. You learn to pick up on people's triggers. So I can tell when lads are struggling. They
yeah.
can tell when I'm struggling.
Yeah.
And even just like a little quiet word or a little coffee after training. It's nothing. It's not major stuff. It's not like we're having a sit down or holding hands and kumbaya.
Yeah.
It's just...
We're not in sandals, darling.
Yeah, it's just... just a little bit of empathy, a bit of emotional intelligence, and it's not so much shutting off and I'll just get on with it. I mean, if I was struggling and something, I went to one of my mates and they were like, you got to get on with it, mate, you just got to push through it, this, that, and the other, we've all, blah, 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 blah. You know, we've all had it.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, what are you putting me? You're putting me in a tricky position here. Actually, sometimes you just need an arm around you. And you know, it's going to be okay. I think you know what I'm ahead about being a listening mate, because that's probably the toughest thing. I think blokes especially want to find a solution.
Okay.
So like, if I say, I'm, you know, if a mate comes to me like, oh, I'm struggling with this and the other, it's like, right, how can we do this, blah, 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 and, you know, give me a million quick fixes. And actually sometimes they just need someone to listen.
Yeah.
And it's not so much about finding a solution right now.
Yeah.
It's just being a sounding board.
And also, I think the smallest things can make the biggest difference.
Yeah, and also, you know, trusting that person to kind of keep that conversation between you.
Yeah.
All you need to be is a soundboard.
Yeah.
You don't have to, you know.
Be a rocket scientist.
have to fix all the problems in the world in half an hour over a coffee.
No.
Sometimes it's just good to sit there, and that is often really appreciated,
yeah.
Even if they don't tell you at the time.